Appreciate you guys being here, and I think there's a lot on the schedule this week where you guys will be able to learn a lot, hopefully meet some new friends, and have a lot of fun.
Dynamic stretching is really, really good for warming things up. So the goal of the dynamic drills that we do are to try to prime your muscles and get them ready to fire in a way that we want them to when we're running. So if I gave you everything and everything is what I bought, I can take it all back. I never care about what you thought. I didn't mean to make you mad. I don't like when you upset. I'ma call you later on, baby girl, don't you forget. If you can just get more range of motion to generate more power, right there, it's additional speed without getting any faster.
Once you stand up really tall, pull it tight and you should feel it deep here in your glute, right?
And if you do this and you got your leg kicking way out to the side, you're also not getting a good stretch. So let's just get each leg for about 15 seconds. We'll call it a day.
Astounding Alex. Kind Kyler. Oh no, that's not video.
Yeah, don't screw it up.
Dabbing Dalton.
I don't get it.
You gotta.
I just know he like kind of a grunt.
You gotta.
You gotta say ka-chow. Do it half whoa, but it's
like
actually dab.
It's the next level stuff. That's just
interesting. All right.
We're gonna do a little seminar here in about 15 minutes, but before that, we have a bunch of ice cream over here for you guys to just kind of chow down on. If you happen to be lactose intolerant like myself, I have 2 pounds of gummy bears. 1 pound's for me, but you guys can share the rest of it.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Oh wow, I'm so good at ice cream scooping.
You guys tonight about form and mechanics. Don't look ahead, don't cheat.
The official definition is the physical parameters one looks at to maximize running economy.
Alright, with running you can make things really complicated or you can keep things really simple. I personally prefer to keep things really simple. So for me, it's just simply how you move when you run and how efficient you are. You don't have to be perfect, you don't have to be Eliud Kipchoge, but just try to be the best that you can be. Be aware of these things, learn them, and if you're serious about getting better as a runner, which I'm sure you are if you're here, then take these things into account and just try to get yourself better. Cool? All right. That is all I have got. Does anybody have any questions? It's a Friday, I'm about to go off. Got my chains on and I'm about to show off. DJ Snake up my head, about to go off. Small stress to get rid of all the stress. On the grind, gunning for the chase. Dino, don't know the half. Dino, don't know the half. See the clothes, see the cash. Getting high for the low stack. Dino, don't know the half. Dino, don't know the half. Swear to God, Dino, don't know the half. Rewind now.
What are the single most important workouts of the week? The recovery days.
Wow,
you're rallying. You're doing good. Yes, it's the hardest thing for an elite athlete to do is run slow on the recovery day. To the Africans, we're going to use them again. They're the best. The slower they go, the better, because now they're firing up their engine, ready, they're recovered.
And I'm going to do a nice big broad lateral squat walk. Back to the middle, flat as a board, hold. Anybody have any guesses on the primary physical performance components? So what goes into having peak performance? So strength, speed, flexibility, coordination, and endurance. So all of these play a role into us being the best athlete we can be. Obviously, some are going to matter depending on what sport you're in. So you guys are distance runners. A lot of what you do, we care about your endurance. However, it's not to say these things also aren't important. And the further along you get in the sport, these things start to matter a lot more. So. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn. But I won't be done when morning comes. Doing it all night, all summer. Gonna spend it like no other. It was a crush, but I could.
nice quick frequency. Let's take it from this cone down to that cone. Remember frequency. Think about bringing that knee and toe straight up. Are going to do a little bit of form analysis, so if anybody wants to stick around here, we're just going to have you kind of work with them and do some casual strides on the infield here, where they can help give you a little bit more feedback on exactly, you know, maybe what you can improve on. Edition run winners. Our male runner predicted a time of 7 minutes and 30 seconds, and he came across the line in 7 minutes and 27 seconds. 3 seconds off. Mr. Gavin Hu, come on. And then on the women's side, Katie was only 3 seconds off as well. Both of our winners were only 3 seconds off.
I was only 35 seconds off.
No, I'm going to announce the biggest deficit here. And that one belongs to Miss Evelyn Lurch, who ran 54 seconds faster than she predicted. So maybe we should be a little more confident going forward. So we're going to do a really basic exercise here really quick. I want to encourage you guys to take a moment, head over there, sit down at a table, and I want you to think about your goals for the upcoming year. So your goals are something, they're something personal, but goals mean nothing unless you tell somebody else. Why is that? It's accountability, okay?
My goal for the season is to recover better.
I want to be in the top 5 at my state meet. I want to take a breather and hype myself up more.
I'm going to break 20 minutes in 5K.
Come top 10 at state.
Break 5 in the mile.
To make nationals for cross country.
My goal is to make it to the state meet next year.
Qualify for states.
So I want to be top three at cross country states.
Break 18:30 in the 5K.
Go to states.
My goal is to make all state.
For the 5K, I want to go sub 20.
I want to place top 5 at states.
So I want to make sure that I keep my teammates motivated.
To make it to the state meet this year.
To get over my heel problems and stay healthy.
Goal is just like have fun more.
So I want to break 16 minutes in the 5K.
Well, if we're setting goals but we fall short of them, that's not failure. What is failure in this situation?
Quitting.
Not going for it, right? We talked about the goal of simply finding out how good you can be, okay? If your goal is to get 10th at the state meet and you give everything you've got and you get 11th, you are successful. Cool? All right. You guys have been super awesome this week. All right.